Christians, not everywhere, really haven't had much here in downtown, but there has been at least some light rain and just a sign that the weather pattern is beginning to change a little bit here and will turn more unsettled later on today and heading into tonight. So just know that you might want to keep the umbrella handy here the next several days as our rain chances start to go up a little bit. Not much out there, nothing severe. We are tracking some rain in Montgomery County, also up near Lafayette. Some of this now heading into Clinton County as well, and in the northwestern sections now of Boone County, and then additional rain now pulling out of Hartford City and heading off towards Ohio. So a little unsettled here. Healthier rain sitting out through St. Louis and southern Illinois. A lot of that will be staying to the south, it looks like, for today. Now, our best storm chance really doesn't get going, it looks like, until late tonight and into the overnight hours. We have a lot of unsettled weather, dangerous weather, in fact, out in southwestern Iowa now. Strong wind gusts there and heavy downpours. And some of that energy will eventually migrate to the east and get back into India, it looks like, sometime late tonight. Now, heading out the door, it is dry here in downtown. As I mentioned, a lot of dry interstates here to begin the morning. We're currently at 72 here in downtown, 70 in Lafayette, 68 up the road in Prue. As we look to our Colts training camp forecast again today, just a slight shower chance at Grand Park. Other than that, the weather should be pretty good heading out there. Not too hot, as we'll have a mix of sun and clouds. And by the time things start to wind down here at about noontime, we'll be at 81 in case you're heading out to Hamilton County later on this morning to, again, watch the Colts practice get underway. As we head into this afternoon, highs in the mid to upper 80s, another day above average and actually the warmest of the work week here. We will start to see a cool down beginning tomorrow as additional rain starts to come back in the forecast here later on tonight. Now, by 3 o'clock today, yes, there could be a shower, maybe an isolated thunder shower on the radar. I still think we're going to see some big gaps of dry weather late afternoon, early evening, as all the energy will be focused back out towards the west. Now, eventually this will drift into our area late tonight. So as of right now, severe weather chances look to be after midnight and into early tomorrow morning. So this will likely be an overnight event where we could be dealing with wind damage and some warnings. So just know, you want to have the phone nearby later on tonight, certainly for any warnings that may go off on your phone for your community, your county, your town. You can see the storms racing on through here 3 a.m. tomorrow morning. They'll be heading off quickly to the east and southeast, and then we'll be back to, it looks like, rather cloudy skies tomorrow and a cooler day. Still some peaks of sunshine, but still a slight shower chance will be in the mix as well. As we look to our 7-day forecast now, it looks like 84 degrees tomorrow, 83 on Wednesday. There's that pullback, 81 going into Thursday. Our rain chances go down each and every day. They'll start to go back up, it looks like, by the weekend, along with the heat. Britt?
Jim, thank you. We don't have any new crash.